and welcome all. I am Mercy, a graduate student at CSIR Institute of Genomics and Integrative Biology. I am pursuing my PhD in Dr. Vinod Scaria's lab. Our lab primarily works on genome informatics, where we computationally analyze genomic data of organisms to have a better understanding of their functional mechanisms. As a part of my PhD, I have been primarily focusing on computational immunology. And for the past 6 to 7 months, we have been actively involved in COVID genomics work also. So in this video, I would like to share with you some basic concepts of SARS-CoV-2 mutations and their ideal significance in human immune responses. So to start with introducing this pathogen, it is an RNA virus called SARS-CoV-2, Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2, with a genome size of approximately 30,000 base pairs, which is comparatively larger than any other commonly known RNA viruses. So like any other pathogen, SARS-CoV-2 also evolves by accumulating mutations in its genome over a period of time. So ever since its initial breakout in China, there has been constant efforts taken worldwide to keep track of evolution of this pathogen by vigilantly monitoring the variations occurring in its genetic architecture. So as of now, we have over 3 lakhs of SARS-CoV-2 genomes sequenced and thousands of genetic variations identified and made available in numerous public resources. So ideally, a viral genome on an average carries 10 to 15 genetic variations in comparison to the standard reference genome sequence. But these variations are just chance events which might or might not have a significant impact on the viral properties. We could say that not all mutations are important. Rather, those that have a significant role in pathogenesis, infectivity, or in immune response are the ones which should be taken into utmost consideration. So one of the ideal examples which I could give here is the D614G variant occurring in the spike protein of this virus. Here, a single amino acid change from aspartic acid to glycine occurring at the 614th position of spike protein was found to have a strong association with the increased infectivity of this pathogen. So currently, we have numerous experimental evidences which have evaluated the functional role of these genetic variants. We also have so many studies which have reported variants that are associated with the protein stability, transmissibility, and also in immune escape mechanisms. So now, I would like to take you through the concept of immune escape variants. So like any other mutations, these are also mutations emerging in the virus, which help the virus to maintain its fitness and virulence against host and therapeutic antibodies. So to talk about this in more detail, the spike protein of this virus is majorly responsible for its entry into human host cells by effectively interacting with human angiotensin converting enzyme 2, which is commonly known as the ACE2 receptor. So this particular protein becomes a major target for host immune responses during an infection or in any therapeutic trials. Genetic variations occurring in this protein were suggested to have a strong consequence in altering the human immune response. So in very simple terms, we can say that immune escape variants are a set of variations which help the virus to retain its ability to effectively bind with ACE2 receptor even in the presence of any competing antibody. So one of the foremost thoughts which we could have now is, how are these variants identified and studied? So these variants are usually studied by analyzing naturally circulating SARS-CoV-2 genetic variants in critical domains like the receptor binding domain in spike protein of this pathogen. So these variations are tested against a range of clinically approved monoclonal or neutralizing antibodies. There are also studies where they have tested these variants with the patient's polyclonal sera. One of the foremost studies which reported immune escape variants was back in the month of November, where they have detailed the immune evasion mechanism of one variant called N439K in receptor binding domain of this pathogen. So currently, we have a handful of studies which have reported potential immune escape variants in SARS-CoV-2 virus. So like I've told before, these are a group of variations which needs stringent monitoring in order to fight this pandemic in an effective way. Our team here at IGIB, we tried developing an online resource called ESC, which is a comprehensive manually curated repository of immune escape variants in SARS-CoV-2 virus. In this resource, currently we have documented a list of about 126 unique variants, primarily spanning the spike protein of this virus, and they were tested against over 70 antibodies curated from literature evidences. So in this resource, we also provide the users with extensive computationally predicted functional annotations, population frequencies, and also corresponding antibody information for each variant. So currently, we have limited entries in this resource, but we hope to maintain this database highly updated in order to cope up with the new discoveries regarding immune escape variants in this virus. And we also hope that this effort would serve as an useful contribution to the scientific community in getting to know more about this pathogen and in fighting this pandemic in an effective way. Thank you.